We are committed to getting the Pacific system out as soon as we can. Every day that we are there later, the problem keeps growing. So we want to work on a really high pace, and that means doing a lot of tests very quickly, do a lot of analysis very quickly, and then go out with the system into the Pacific. The biggest challenge in the engineering team that we have is that the system is so new. So we cannot use a lot of existing technology to pick components from and use it. It's a fairly simple system that we are designing, but there are so many new aspects in it and so many unknowns that we really need to thoroughly look into them. We are doing a new test in the North Sea to verify our new and updated design. The system changed quite a bit after the previous North Sea prototype. We changed the system from being moored to the seabed to being free floating. And that makes that we need stiffness in the barrier to keep the system open, to have plastics entering the system. And with the previous system design, that was not possible because that was a completely flexible barrier. In the previous one, we had a rubber type barrier which had inflatable chambers to make it buoyant. And we changed that into a HDPE solid pipe. And below that, we connect a screen that prevents the plastic from going underneath the floater. We are going to test two 12 meter sections of barrier with a different type of screen connection. One of them is where the screen is wrapped around the floater. So we have the HDPE pipe, the screen is hanging on the underside and it's going around like a surf sail. The other design is where the screen is connected to the underside of the floater. We make a profile on the floater where we can connect the screen to. We are also testing here the application of antifouling coating on the screen. Part of the screen is coated and a part is not. And in that way we can see the differences in marine growth that we will encounter on the screen if we apply this coating. Because in the Pacific system we want to prevent marine growth as much as we can. The test setup that we now have in the North Sea will not be a drifting system. It will be more to the seabed as the previous North Sea prototype was. The conditions that we see in the North Sea are harsher than we see in the Pacific. The waves are higher, the winds are stronger and the currents are higher, which makes this a very suitable endurance test location. For this North Sea prototype, we again rely on our partnership with Boskalis, and they bring a lot of knowledge and experience with them to make this installation a success. So the day of the installation of the system on site is quite a big day. A lot needs to happen. The system needs to be brought offshore, the system needs to be put into the water, it needs to be connected to the buoys that are there. So it's quite an eventful day where a lot of things happen and everything falls into place. So the system is assembled onshore, then the system is put on a ship, it's brought offshore, and all the connections are made, and then the system is lifted into the North Sea where it is floating and then connected to the buoys that are already installed. And at the end of the day we have the prototype system in operation.